Hi everyone, we're back to bring clarity to your life with more IT basics. And this time, we're gonna answer this question. What is ITAM? Ready? I can't hear you. No, really, I can't hear you. This was recorded like a month ago. Let's get started. ITAM, or ITAM for short, stands for IT Asset Management, which basically means, well, managing all the assets in your organization. It's a type of business management that's directly connected to your organization's IT infrastructure. Asset, noun. Everything in your organization that doesn't breathe. It could be hardware, like servers, computers, printers, etc. Software, like antivirus or Microsoft Office. All network and non-network devices, like keyboards, and even desks and chairs. How do you know how much stuff, assets, you have in your organization? At the beginning of time, we used to count our belongings and simply remember them. Later on, we started writing lists, then those lists became more organized with spreadsheets. But updating those on a daily basis was a real pain in the ass-set. Huh? Nowadays, things are much easier. Basically, because there is a lot of dedicated software for asset management that helps you manage your assets in a very efficient way. Okay, but why is that important to keep track of all your assets? Aha! Well, it'll help you with all your IT tasks, I promise. Let's go deeper and I'll explain. So in our previous video, we talked about the three most important and widely used ITSM processes. Incident, problem, and change management. Now, we want to show you how asset management can help you with these processes. If in the next minute you have no idea what I'm talking about, please watch our What is ITSM video first. 1. Incident management. Let's say that a user opened a ticket saying, "Every time I try to install Skype, it fails. Help me." When typing the user's name into the asset management software, you'll see the entire list of assets that they're using. In that list, you'll also be able to see that his hard drive has run out of free space and that this is most likely the reason for the installation failure. And all that without even getting out of your office. Problem identified, you clean up the disk space, problem solved, and you save precious time. Mic drop. Pen drop. 2. Problem management. Let's say that you got a few tickets from different users during the week saying, "The internet is so slow, help me, OMG!" With good asset management, you'll immediately be able to see that all of the complainers have something in common. They all had their Chrome browser upgraded during the weekend. After a quick investigation, you find out that there was a bug in the new Chrome version. So, you can easily fix it by reverting the browser to the older version. You found the cause of the problem that, otherwise, without asset management, would have taken ages to figure out. Voila! Problem solved! 3. Change management. Making changes in your organization is a scary thing. There's always risk involved. If things won't go as planned, you will probably find yourself in deep trouble. Let's say you've decided to update everybody's antivirus software to the newest version. With asset management, you will know that most people in your organization are running Windows 10, yet 3 people are still running Windows 7. But the new version of the antivirus software does not support Windows 7. By knowing which user is using which operating system, you've just saved a lot of time and headache and made the change much smoother and more efficient. There are a lot of other advantages for using asset management, such as helping with your IT budget. Now that's a big one. Using asset management, you can generate a report that shows you all the computers in your organization that have warranties ending within the next 12 months. Based on that info, you'll know how much money to put into your budget for new computers. There's much more, but the one thing you should always remember is that in order to manage an IT infrastructure, it's necessary to know about all the parts it's comprised of. Thankfully, modern IT asset management software offers the key to success here. IT asset management applications can detect the hardware, software, and network assets across your organization and then capture, record, and make the IT asset management data available as needed. In SysAid, for example, asset management is integrated with the service desk, keeping all the user and asset data together with the incidents and requests, all on the same screen, everything connected, making it even easier and much more convenient to keep track of. I'm just saying. Thank you for watching, and see you at our next video.